Welcome to lockdown day 11, and now that we've got the workshop more or less done, bottomed out, I've taken some stuff to the storage units, and I've got this here, so I thought I'd quickly show you this, and then we'll do a bit of a fleet update, I think, tonight. It's now 7:15. I've had domestic nonsense taking up the rest of the day, so we're catching the last rays. And this is something that you'll see when it's been recommissioned. Recommissioning is what it needs, really. It's a model that ran through from the 60s right through to the 80s. I think this is 70s, and it's a Schauff, S-C-H-A-U-F-F, German brand. They were sold in batches and branded to other companies, but Schauff are the makers, and that's what this one was. It used to be quite a dull metallic blue, and Raven painted it quite some time ago now, about 8 years ago, in Bianchi Celeste. And I've got a nice pump which was taken from a Bianchi that I had that was the same colour. This one has Sturmey Archer Steelite hubs, which aren't original. They were in my Pashley Courier. This originally had just caliper brakes, but really for a tandem it's good to have some better braking. So a proper front rack to support the basket. That's how I prefer to support baskets, on a rack. Alloy rims, and the original crank sets. You see they're the one-sided bottom brackets on these. Fine for something like this. This was only ever meant as a leisure and family transport tandem, and yeah, the seating is a bit uncomfortable at the moment. That's a Marshall's sash from a World Naked Bike Ride. How it's still on there I don't know. It's had cork grips on there. I've got some better levers to put on to give a bit extra pull on these brakes. That was one of the things it needed. It was last out on a Tweed Ride about 4 years ago, maybe five, four I think, in Manchester. And so it's got... life is good. And the bits and pieces to go on it are in there. Of course it has to have Society of Three Speeds on there. And Copenhagen Cycle Chic and Society of Three Speeds. When you paint a bike and you haven't got graphics for it, it's like a blank canvas with stickers, really. That is a little leather, that is leather, with shellacked twine. I do it on quite a few of my bikes, on the top tube usually, to protect from locks, from scratching from locks and such like. On a step over bike like this one, step through bike, sorry, it stops the shoe scuffs. That's its purpose. And you can tell these tandems because the bridge plate on the seat stays is an S. If you've got that S, it's a Schauff. Mudguards aren't original either. There's some nice stainless steel ones. A nice rear lamp from an Electra. And that on the back, because it was an Easter Tweed Ride, actually, it was on. And the Ellswick, the rally built Ellswick hopper, and just waiting to go back in. I've had a couple of bikes out so that I could use the step ladders to get up to find things. The purple Moulton's still waiting patiently. It's going to have things growing around it shortly. My Superb, you saw the other day I was out on it. Nothing really to update on there. The Ellswick is officially for sale still, but of course things like bike sales are kind of suspended at the moment because of the difficulty of delivering and collecting. Nice comparison, those two next to each other though. The same green, the same frame. And now we come in It's a bit stingy in here. A couple of light bulbs have gone, so something's jamming in the door now as I'm trying to do it on camera. Yeah, we've got a light bulb or two out at the moment, and it's difficult to get out and get things like that. The lovely gold gazelle that was new old stock when I found it. Again, nothing to do on that one. It just soldiers on. Gives me immense pleasure every time I take it out. It rides like the three-speed bicycle equivalent of a Rolls Royce. Absolutely glorious bike, will never be sold. The 1967 Rally Riviera. You saw that a few days ago as well, out and about. It needs a lube. It was put away dirty, but it still needs a clean as well. Yeah, it's still quite, that's mud, not rust on there. So it needs a clean and a lube. The cables are all a little bit on the stiff side. Poor thing's been neglected, so a service I think is on the cards for that one. As for upgrades and updates, nope, it's fine. The old Union Arizona from the 1960s. If you look back to my Spring Equinox rides, this was one of those. So I tell the story there about how it was pulled out of an Amsterdam canal by the mechanical grab. The frame all mangled and I've straightened it and it's a lovely ride now. I did that ride in the countryside on these original old tyres that I've always wondered whether they were okay for something like that. They're absolutely fine. So if I can find a folding tyre in the 26 1 3/8 size, if such a thing exists, I'll buy one to take with me on rides on bikes with older tyres fitted. I just have this vision of one of these old things blowing out on me and me being stranded. Otherwise, again, it needs nothing. It's running beautifully now, better than ever. Very pleased with it. The beautiful original Hopper. Again, it needs a clean. You see, my bikes get ridden. They're built to be ridden. And I ride them. I look after them, take care of them, but I don't pamper them and cosset them like you would think an Asperger's geek like me would do. I actually like to ride the things, use them, and take care of them. So, yeah, it's dirty. Like several of the others, it really needs a clean. Doesn't need anything else. It's absolutely spot on. Another lovely ride, even though it's an inch small for me, as you can see by the seat height. Again, that went out recently on a ride. The sunny ramble on the Hopper. The video is further down the stream. And you see me putting the saddle up a little bit on that video. So, tick off that one. Doesn't need anything. Right, the cycling equivalent of my best mate. It's my custom Bob Jackson that was made for me in 1998. If I look at what this needs, there's always something, because I'm always trying to just tweak it and refine it. But really, we're talking infinitesimal changes. It's got some classic LX levers on, which they just pull slightly too much cable and they're a bit harsh. I'd maybe like some more and some longer, softer levers on. Yeah, I can't really think of anything else. However, I do have something in the bag for this bike. My complaint, if you look at my video on this bike, my complaint about it is mostly centered around the front forks. It was built as bikes were built at the time, and by modern standards and the changes in tastes and advancements in knowledge about tyres and suppleness and tyre width, really the forks are too narrow. And that fork crown is not wide enough, and the fork length is not enough, so the height, the clearance above, is not enough to take anything more than a 32mm tyre, and that's a squeeze, as you can see. And these, the original Ritchie brakes, Ritchie Logic cantilevers, are really just a tad close together. So, and also I've started carrying a front bag in the, well, recent times, about the last 12 years. For a front bag, it ideally would need a little bit more rake, the axle about here, which gives lower trail, which improves the handling when you're carrying a front load. So I've always wanted, for a few years now, a good 531 lugged fork with a wider crown and slightly more rake, but still with the brazons. And I have such a thing, and we'll come to that in a couple of minutes. Here's another bike that you've yet to have a video on. It's a customised Rally Misty. See, the Misty never had forks like that on it either. That's they're from Royal Tour, I think. Mixed bike, it was Raven's. It was rebuilt for her, the choice of colours and such like. But I've de-derailed it. It's got a 3-speed in the back now, and it's getting a pair of the Rally alloy single cranks from a late Superb under that chain wheel, that chain guard. And it all got put aside because Raven's health deteriorated, and she was unable to ride it, and she got a couple of e-bikes, and so the e-bikes became, one after the other, became her staple, and this got put aside. That's a frame lock on there, painted to match. So this is actually waiting to have an e-bike kit put in it. However, that's going to be a while. Can't really afford anything like that at the moment. So I think I'm going to just recommission it, and it's still a nice 3-speed bike. I can knock about on it if necessary. Yeah, so that's Scarlet, it's called, this bike. Have to show you these wrapped handlebars. How beautiful is that? That came when I used to import Clarice Fietztassen panniers, and that was one of the little extras for that. Right, what's next? Right, next up is the Koga Signature Traveller, which I was out on the other day, one of, I think, lockdown day 3 might have been this one. And I mentioned then it's in need of a tyre swap. In fact, you saw me getting the tyres muddy on that video. These are marathon racers. These are going on a bike you'll see in a minute, instead of a pair of cyclocross tyres. And this is getting some marathon touring tyres on, more appropriate for the bike. These tyres are fairly slick. I mean, they are quite new, these. And that's as much tread as they come with. They've only done 100 miles or so, maybe. So they can go on, good fellow. So I won't go through that bike again. It's in here for that tyre swap. And nothing much else, really. The Massive Union you saw on an early lockdown video as well. It needs the shifter looking at. The 3-speed shifter, I think the cable might be unseated inside the shifter slightly. It's very vague gear changes, and it's self-shifting sometimes. So I shall take care of that. Apart from that, it's just a lovely, lovely bike to ride. Brownie, the big bronze gazelle. You can see it's got no pedals on. It had some classic mountain bike pedals on, which came off my 1984 Claude Butler. When I sold the Claude Butler, I took the pedals off to go with the bike because the new owner wants to return it to standard. And yeah, it's sat here over winter, really, to stop it deteriorating too much. This is one bike that I suppose I do pamper and I don't get dirty. It does happen sometimes. Yeah, it's still got the horn on it from the last tweed ride that I did in Liverpool last autumn. So I'll put some pedals on it. In the medium term, it needs one crank replacing. And the right hand side crank has got a little bit pitted and rusty, but really that's just finickety. It's a gorgeous bike. There is a video on it, but I think when I put these pedals on, I think I'll take this out in the next 2 or 3 days and have a little ride around on it, reacquaint myself and make a nice little video. Behind that, we'll go straight into the next one, which is the Batavus 2-speed. Lovely custom bike. It's got that Mafac front brake, and then you see the inverse lever for it there. And that's cloth tape under there with lots of shellac on top, and a cork in the end which needs some shellac on it. It needs a Brooks saddle putting back on it. This saddle needs to go on that tandem that you saw outside. And the rear hub, I have explained it, and there's a special video on that hub. It's a Fictalan Sachs Duomatic 2-speed without cables. And it's got a back pedal brake in it as well. The Gazelle Path Racer, that's another thing that needs to come out and have a blast. So maybe this next 2 or 3 days I will get out the Path Racer and the big brown Gazelle and have a good old blast on those and show you. Now, there is a series of 3 videos further down my feed about recommissioning a neglected Gazelle. This is the Gazelle. It's still in good condition, except that shortly after I recommissioned it, the rear hub disintegrated itself. It really did. It is, let me show you, it's a Sturmey Archer of the modern type, a Sunrace Sturmey Archer, and it is in this tray here on a project shelf. And you can't really see very much of it here because it's all stripped out. That's actually just a case of it. That's the brake side. The drive side, the bearing collapsed and it tore its innards apart. The bits and pieces are all in a box now. That looks like some of them in there. And it's just been put aside. The planet gears stripped themselves completely, the main cage cracked, so yeah, the innards really did blow themselves apart. The casing is fine, so I'll keep the casing, and I'm just going to part the hub. So I thought, should I put an old-fashioned Sturmey Archer AB in there, which is the old equivalent of this, a 3-speed with a drum brake. I have a couple of those, and I was prepared to put that in. And then I looked in the pile and I thought, oh, hang on, I know what I've got here. What I've got here is this. I've now built this wheel for the bike, and the nerds among you will have already seen that it is a Shimano Nexus 8-speed hub, and it is complete with the roller brake, which is in the Nexsave range, but it's an expanding roller brake for this hub. So I built it into this wheel, into the original rim, with some nice stainless steel spokes, a 22 tooth sprocket, so it'll have a lovely range of gears, and then that is going in there. So that's definitely a future video. The conversion of this to an 8-speed. Be interesting to see how much more usable it is in different conditions, because it was definitely a flat country bike. It'd be nice to be able to take this one out a little bit more.
So let's see how that progresses.
Now, leaning against the bench here, we have Goodfellow, my poor man's Rivendell, still with the cover on where I demonstrated to you how they work. That's got a leather top tube cover on it as well. And you can see it's missing its rear wheel. The reason for that is quite simple. The rim, I can't really show you on a video, the rim has a flat spot in it. Yeah, there's a slight bump, bump, bump as you go around. Shame, because there's very little rim wear, but it's got itself a flat spot somewhere. So I have another rim ready to go on, and then that is getting a re-rim. And it's getting these Marathon Racer tyres off the Koga in there. I was about to put a pair of Racing Ralph cyclocross tyres in the autumn, but then the autumn went past, the winter went past, it's now spring, so it's going to get the Marathon Racers. I'll save the cyclocrosses for the winter. It has had one of my favourite touring tyres, the Panaracer Pasela Tour Guard. Excellent, excellent tyres. But the back one in particular is about done now. They're 38mm, these. Yeah, the back one's about gone, so time for some new ones. Now, if you look at the other video, you'll notice this now has a different fork. It's a one-piece fork, Unicrown, which I don't like aesthetically, but never mind. It has the same rake, same dropouts and everything as the original fork, but crucially it has much more clearance both sideways and height-wise, because this front fork was also a pinch. It'll take a 35mm fine, won't take the 38s that I wanted in there. This one will now take 40s, and the rear frame is fine to take 40s. So it's going to get those 40mm Marathon Racers in, and that'll transform the ride of this bike. It used to have a cheap little rack in that bike, which I will now show you because it's hanging up behind me. It used to have this rack on it. Can't complain, it only cost about 11 quid. But really it wasn't what I needed. These mount onto the cantilever brake mounts, and then I had a bracket from these two holes onto the fork crown, and from the front of here to the mudguard, just to keep the mudguard steady, because I like a lot of front overhang on the mudguards. Trouble with this rack is, this is a rivet, so these are adjustable, which means that when it's on the bike, it had a tendency to just tip itself forward a little bit. The reason that these are adjustable is that you can also use it on the rear. You can hang it on the rear cantilever mounts like that and then pivot it, and it becomes a little saddlebag support. So it's not a bad thing, and it was cheap. It just wasn't what I really wanted on this bike. But it served its purpose for about 5 years. I've now gone the route of a full front rack, and that threads its way through the Blackburn lowriders down to the bottom there, and little short mudguard stays which run off the back of the fork on the lowrider mounts. So tiny little mudguard stays, that'll give a nice flap-free attachment for the mudguard. And then to match the rear, I have a wooden panel ready to go in there, which will match the rear, which already has the wood in there. My excuse being I've run out of sticker space. So that bike's been getting some upgrades. Oh, and another upgrade. I finally relented and put a V-brake on the front. A high quality one, an LX. Which of course you can't get anymore now. Anything up the range like that is a disc nowadays. So that's everything that's in here, and isn't down at the unit, except of course for our old friend Project Dawn. I've left Project Dawn in the stand specifically, I'm determined not to move it out of the stand until I've done the damn thing. Excuse me, it needs the wheels putting back in and the brakes assembling, which I want to do videos of. I have the wheels down here. I'm halfway through getting down to bare metal on the rims after someone had applied several coats of silver paint onto it. Never paint your rims silver, it's horrible. And I'm going back down to the metal. It won't be pristine chrome by any means, and that's fine. It will be patina to match the rest of the bike. So that's not far off now. A Raleigh Roadster Club member kindly sent me the clip that I needed to attach the chain guard. The chain guard is a fake, that's in another video as well. It's a fake as in it's a brand new one, and I've added patina to it. So Project Dawn will be done presently as part of these lockdown projects. However, I have a couple of domestic projects to do in here at the moment. So tonight, that's what I'm going to be doing. I have to refurbish a little cabinet and do a couple of other little jobs. One of which I will show you because it's bicycle related. I'll show you when I do it. It's for the house, but it's made out of bicycle parts. A bit of repurposing, and why not? So, those of you who have been paying attention might now put two and two together and realise that these nice forks that came out of Goodfellow are actually just the job for Bob Jackson, and that's what will be happening. So once again I'll say stay safe. I hope we get through this whole debacle of the coronavirus without losing any of our own. That'll be nice. And I'll see you again tomorrow, whether it's a tinkering in here or whether it's a ride out remains to be seen. How the weather is, how I am, how my schedule is, but one way or the other there will be a new video tomorrow. There has been a response to my inquiry about a book a day. The response has been small but positive, so I'll probably get around to that. That's definitely going to be a filler in between normal videos. But in the meantime, I wish you all well. Stay safe, keep riding if you can, and we'll see you tomorrow. Oh dear. Ah, dear.